Most eukaryotic genes contain segments of coding sequences, called exons, and non-coding sequences, called introns. The introns are removed, or spliced out, after transcription, but before the RNA transcript leaves the nucleus. A few short nucleotide sequences provide the cell with cues of what to remove. The elaborate molecular machine that carries out this task is called the spliceosome, which consists of five RNA protein complexes called snRPs. In the first step, the U1 snRP recognizes and binds to the 5' splice site by base pairing with it. A branch point binding protein, BBP, and the helper protein, U2AF, recognize and bind the branch point adenine within the intron. Next, the U2 snRP base pairs with the branch point site, displacing the bound proteins. Now, the U4-U6-U5 triple snRP comes into play. U4 and U6 are initially held together tightly, and several RNA rearrangements occur to break the U4 and U6 snRPs apart. This allows U6 to replace U1 at the 5' splice junction. Now in position, the branch point adenine in the intron attacks the 5' splice site, cutting the sugar phosphate backbone of the RNA. The end of the intron covalently bonds to the adenine, forming a lariat structure. The spliceosome rearranges to bring together the exons, allowing the 3' hydroxyl group of the first exon to react with the 5' end of the other. After the two exons are joined into a continuous sequence, the lariat is released and degraded.